Just to start with, we've talked about it there. What has the reaction been to tackle for Manchester so far since you first came up with the idea?
We've had tremendous reaction. And if anything, we've struggled to deal with the amount of help that's been put forward by people. So we're still trying to make sure that we can, you know, accommodate for everyone's energy to kind of be converged into something useful. But the key thing today is to raise as many funds as we can and transport those funds to the people who are actually doing it every single day on the streets.
What is it about this issue in particular that made you want to get behind it and try and make change?
Well, the simple answer is my wife is from Manchester, and it's a discussion that me and Carla were having across the years, and it's always something she wanted to put her shoulders under, and you know, it's kind of transpired onto me in that way. And then as well, you know, we're raising three wonderful children in this world and in this part of the world, and it just doesn't make sense to be as successful as we are and to let these things happen, you know, right next to our door. If I want to be a good dad to my children, and if we want to be good parents to our children, at some stage we have to explain to them why we haven't done anything, and that's just not an option. And so we're putting all of our weight behind it.
You've been really hands-on with the project. What's it been like when you've been out on the streets, and have you spoken to some of those who are living on the streets as well?
Yeah, I mean, I'm very, very clear in what I try to do. So the way I've been out on the street is nothing compared to the hours that are being put in by those who are there every single day. And it's them that we should all, that the credit should go. But my case is very simple. I want to raise funds to support these people who I've seen doing a good job. And it's as simple as that. I don't want to interfere with what they're doing as well by just being another child to mine when they're walking around and they're dealing with serious issues. I've just recognized that a good job is being done. People that are very important for our society need support, and that's what I'm there to do.
In a city like Manchester, does it shock you, the scale of the problem in some parts of the city?
I think it would shock me more if by the end of this there wasn't, if by the end of this there was a lack of solidarity on the issue. Issues happen everywhere. There's no real excuse for it, but it's just the way the world is. But in this part of the world, especially after the Manchester bombing, I would be really surprised to not see a huge surge of solidarity to just deal with it and sort it out. We're at the time where it is possible still, and that's what we're trying to do today.
And tonight's ball, what was it that made you want to organise, you know, a night like tonight?
Well, it's my testimonial year, so I've been 10 years at City. You get a few tokens of gratitude that are being offered along the way, and you know, one of these is a testimonial event. Now, I'm not really the one to be the centre of attention, but in this case, it's an easy way to collect a lot of funds, so I'm doing it for that reason. It's all for the charity, and that's why today's an important night, not for myself, but because of what we're trying to achieve.
And you've got stars like Noel Gallagher involved. Was he keen to get behind it too?
I mean, it was literally, and we had to change the date because the Arsenal game got moved. So and with his busy schedule, I'm still amazed at the fact that he's willing to perform 45 minutes for us today. And that'll be, I'm delighted about this, and I'm very surprised and humbled. Yeah.
And what's great as well is to see, you know, the bosses of City and United in one room together. Yeah. Does this show, you know, it doesn't matter who you support, who you play for, we can all come together and make a difference on this issue.
Yeah, I mean, there is a lot of meaning in that, and we all know the rivalries between the city, between the two clubs in the city, and for the Manchester United manager and the Manchester City manager to come together in one place and, you know, celebrate something which is bigger than that. I'm not meaning my testimonial, I'm talking about the charity. Shows a lot of class on both sides, you know, and it just shows that this city knows when to come together.
And just remind us again what the funds that you raise tonight, what that will go towards.
Well, first and foremost, we'll try and support the Mayor's Fund. the charity call the bed every night, make sure that we can deal with the issue of rough sleeping head on. And, you know, hopefully we'll be able to, so basically with a bed every night, we can provide temporary accommodation for those who are sleeping on the streets, obviously most needed in the winter. Hopefully we'll be able to take it all the way through the year, have 12 months of it, which at the moment is not the case because in the summer months, the shelters get closed. And then ideally is to push as many people as we can into permanent accommodation and with everything that goes with it, you know, hopefully employment and so on and so on. But that's almost on that needs to be discussed in London almost.
But using a platform like yours, though, I mean, did you find it important to raise awareness and, you know, when you've got that back and you've got that following to spread a message like this?
Yeah, and it's an opportunity, really. I mean, I can't think of how many people would love to be doing something substantial and but just don't have the voice for it or don't have the ability to do it. So it'd be a waste if I didn't do it. And you know, it's meaningful. So not just for myself, but for my wife, for my kids, for the entire family who lives here in Manchester. And we'd love to play a part in it.